This is going to be probably the hardest video I've had to make for many reasons, and to be transparent with y'all, nothing fancy really gonna be in this video. I'm gonna keep it simple, and I'm just gonna try to share my heart. So if you'd be willing to stay to the end, give me a shot, hear me out, that would bless me, and you'll see why. The way that I told myself that I would get through this video was basically just trying to talk to y'all as if you are my wife, my best friend, Joanna. She is the person in this world who has seen me at my most vulnerable. She is the person in this world who has shown me that I can be vulnerable. And interestingly enough, at least if I'm able to, this will be my most vulnerable video yet. The reality is that it's extremely difficult for me personally to be vulnerable, to share about myself. Part of the reason why it's so hard for me to talk about myself is because in Christian culture, you're taught forever that all the glory goes to God. And for some reason, at least in my mind, that equates to hiding and diminishing yourself and your contributions to the highest maximum way that you can, so that if something glorious were to happen, God would take the glory. I remember at my last job, I had a staff member, Susan, who once told me, "Eric, you need to share more about yourself with the staff. We want to hear about you." And I remember in that moment, I was just like, nah, there's no way that these people want to hear about my life. Like, I think that this week, as I was thinking about making this video, I realized that most of my life, I've just internalized this message that nobody really cares about me. And they only really care about what I can do for them. And so when I was leading the team at my previous job, and all throughout my life, I've really done everything that I can to present well to people. I have not always done the greatest job. If you know me, you know that I have my fair share of mess ups. But I've always tried. I've always tried to appear strong enough. I've always tried to be the best version of myself that I could possibly be for people. I always felt like that's what people needed from me. I remember when one of my closest friends, Christian, died. I didn't cry until months later. I didn't cry until the wake and funeral was completely over. And I remember breaking down in the car with Joanna. And now I think back to that time and I'm like, yeah, I remember distinctly that everybody was looking to me for strength, and that in those moments, I was there for them, and I gave them a shoulder to cry on. But that was an extremely traumatic experience, to lose my friend in the way that I did. And even though I broke down in the car with Joanna when everything was over, and she was there with me, it still felt incredibly lonely to have held all of those emotions inside from many of the people that I loved and loved my friend. But thankfully, being able to share it with one person. And many times in situations like that, even, I usually let it all out and then immediately stop and choose to move on. It's like I choose to be strong whenever I can gather myself. And as I was preparing for this video, I realized we all internalize messages. We all internalize messages that we believe was spoken over us when we were children. And I just remember being a kid, being extremely emotional. And so many people either telling me or with their actions showing me that the level of emotion that I exhibited was unacceptable. So somehow growing up, I believed that if I was too emotional, if I was too real about myself and my struggles, if I was too vulnerable, that would turn people away rather than bring them closer. And interestingly enough, two of the people that I just absolutely love hearing minister and just speak to my life are all about transparency and vulnerability. Vulnerability. Pastor Mike Todd, hot, humble, open, transparent. And Tim Ross from The Basement says that vulnerability is his superpower. And hearing them talk about that, it's like my heart and my spirit accepts it at face value, but then I struggle to live it out. I was just talking to one of my close friends, Josh, on Saturday. He reached out to me. And he straight up told me, listen, bro, I want to be honest with you. And he told me that he struggles to connect with my content because he feels like I'm always holding back. And he feels like I'm not being truly myself. And let me tell you, I've struggled a lot since I started this. I have struggled so much with wondering how I could be fully myself, with wondering if and in what ways people would respond to me being more myself, and how can I talk about myself more, and what stories should I tell that will impact people with the message that I'm trying to bring. And I have not been able to find a healthy medium. And I think that that's probably why I've started to struggle. Now listen, throughout these past 2 years that I've been doing this, I don't know if you are watching this and maybe you don't know, but I went all in, mostly all in for most of the time. And I quit my job, and I felt like God called me to this. And throughout this process, I've had the privilege of meeting other people who were at a similar stage as me. Content creators trying to create content for God. And I've seen how they struggle, and I've many times taken the time to encourage them, to do my best to uplift them. And throughout this process, yo, I feel like I've just been acting like I have it all together. Listen, like Josh told me straight up about my episode, the podcast episode with Joanna. He straight up told me, he's like, yo, y'all kept talking about living and navigating chaos, and then you never talked about it. And he said, Joanna literally said, maybe one day we'll share the story and y'all moved on. And he was right. Like, I had to start thinking, why is it that I hold back so much? And why is it that I struggle so much with sharing about me? And so, interestingly enough, the moment that I'm realizing this is the moment that I'm at the lowest low with Valley of the Heroic. I'm not gonna go ahead and say that this is my last video. I have thought about it this week. And this probably is gonna be like, if anybody watches this, this will be a shock to them, because they'll be like, if I was successful, I probably made it look like I was doing well. And don't get me wrong, spiritually, wow. Spiritually, outside of this week, I have felt absolutely the closest to God that I've ever been. However, financially, financially, we're not doing so well. I don't have too much experience with marketing. Because I struggle with talking about myself, it's hard for me to get myself mentally to a place where I think I'm good enough to monetize or sell something in any way. So I haven't been able to make that conversion. And the reality was that if I was all in with this, I needed to find a way to monetize. And everything inside of me wants to do this for God's glory full time, to do this to bless people's lives. I truly believe that I have something that can help people. I struggled doing it full time, so now that I'm in the process of looking for a job, which I am, and that makes me feel like a complete and utter failure. And I am utterly terrified to publish this video for you to hear that. And for some reason, that somebody would laugh at me and that I'd make God look bad, or there's so many thoughts that come to mind. At this point, the only thing I know that I felt God spoke to me was that I needed to do this, and that I needed to do it in the way that I did it. And I grew so much, so much this past year. And I don't want to undermine that. But I also can't negate the fact that I feel like I failed. I can't negate the fact that I feel like I wasn't able to do it. And granted, who knows where I'll end up a year from now, 2 years from now. But just for you to get an inside look into who I am, I struggle mentally sometimes. I fought depression before. I have very high highs with my emotions and then very low lows with my emotions. I don't have the best self-esteem. I have imposter syndrome. I struggle with motivation. I struggle with believing in myself. I struggle with knowing if I actually heard from God. And Joanna and I just believed in this so strongly. I would never do this without her support. I would never have made such drastic decisions without her support. I would never put my family in a position to compromise them. And now we've reached that point that if nothing changes, I may have to quit or I may have to severely slow down. At this point, thankfully, we haven't struggled with getting food for the most part. Our bills are piling up heavily through some mistake of the car company and a miscommunication. We are behind on our car payments. And we are at the point of being threatened of our car being taken, which I can't let happen. And that was the straw that broke the camel's back for me. And this is the craziest part, because I just don't want you to think that I'm crazy out here. There were points in the past where Joanna was making less money at her job and I was making or bringing in either about the same or less of what I'm bringing in now. And our bank account would literally go negative. And then throughout the next couple days, somehow miraculously, it would creep back up. This happened multiple times. You can ask my wife. I just don't want you to think that I put my family in a position to be in need. There were multiple times where our bank account would creep back up and go above zero without us putting any money in. I did the budget. And our budget was very, very behind. And yet every single month we were making it. We were paying all of our bills. We had two cars at the time. And it was like God was working a miracle. And one day, a couple of months ago, that stopped. Now, I don't want to sit here and like mock God and say, why did you stop? I don't understand. I don't know what happened. But I just want you to know that we have seen God move. And I want to share that miraculous story with you, because some of you might be afraid to act on something that God told you to do. Listen, I'm at a point where I don't know what's next. I don't understand. I don't understand why God spoke to us in the way that he did, called us to do this in the way that he did, confirmed it multiple times in the way that he did miracles, and now we are at a point where we're literally about to lose our car. So I'm sorry. I'm sorry for acting like I had it all together. I'm sorry if you ever felt like I wasn't being real enough. I'm sorry for trying to be strong for you, because the reality is that I'm incredibly weak. And I can only point to any portion of my strength because of God and because of the love of my family. I'm sorry that I didn't do this as well as maybe God wanted me to. I'm sorry for any moments that I may have failed any of you. And yeah. I'm sorry if you felt like you couldn't support this because you know, or felt like I was holding back, or whatever reason, if you felt like it wasn't really what I was capable of. But I'll tell you this, I really tried. I really tried. The reality is that I do love doing this. I love creating this content. If there is still a chance that God would open up a door through this for it to continue and to become whatever it is that God wanted it to become, and if He wants to use me, then I want to take it. I'm just not sure what's going to happen. And I just wanted to be honest with you before whatever's next happens. And especially because of my conversation with Josh. I did not make this video to get any type of response. I felt an obligation to make this video morally. But I would love to have a conversation with any of you about it. You can comment wherever it is that is posted. You can send me a DM on Instagram. You can text me if you know my number. You can go to my website and send me a message there. You can email me. Shoot, you can send me a letter if you want to, whatever. But just hit me up if you want to talk about it. The reality is that in these 2 years, there were definitely times where God held us down. Miraculously. There's so many things I could share. He gave us wisdom on how to manage the money. He had people gift us with money. He had that miraculous thing he did with the bank account. It's just that now that stopped. So something needs to change. And I don't know what. And I don't know if that's me getting a job or somehow miraculously me finding a way to make Valley of the Heroic work. I don't know. I wish I did. I wish I did, but I don't. If you're still here, if you listen to this whole thing, thank you for giving me 25 minutes of your time. Thank you for taking the time to hear me out. And for those of you who do want to become a supporter, if you don't want to see this die, the only real way that I have set up right now is Patreon. It's very similar to ministry. If I were a ministry or a church where you can contribute monthly, you can contribute one time. But I don't know. Maybe some of you say that I'd love to do that. There will be a link below where you can do that, or in my link in bio. Sorry, there's a squirrel that's chilling around me. Normally I'd cut that out, but never mind. But yeah, you can support through Patreon. You can also hit me up if you want to support one time. You can buy a t-shirt. You can invite me to speak. Right now, even if I wanted to continue, the state that we are in right now has been extremely disheartening. So I don't know how much I have to give, but I'll tell you one thing. The most important thing to me in my life has always been to be obedient. So if God somehow does speak to me and tells me to continue, then I'll be back. If I'm walling and this wasn't it, then this will be my last video. Either way, it was a fun ride. Thank you for all of you who have supported by watching and liking, commenting, subscribing. And I hope you guys have an amazing, amazing, amazing life.